Welcome one and all to Country Preaching. Don Drake here. It's good to have you in the listening audience. We invite you to stay around a few minutes, and we'll leave you with a few thoughts, a song, and a message from God's Word. Some Christians never grow up. They merely change their playthings. Some Christians never grow up. They merely change their playthings. Happiness is a perfume you cannot sprinkle on others without getting a few drops on yourself. Here's a thought for today. If it was not for God's grace, we'd all be a disgrace. I want to speak to you a few minutes from the writings of Solomon, Ecclesiastes 11 and 14. He that observeth the wind shall not sow, and he that regardeth the clouds shall not reap. Now listen to it again. He that observeth the winds shall not sow, and he that regardeth the clouds shall not reap. What is he saying? He's saying you'll never find a convenient time to do those things that you ought to do. That's exactly what he's saying. You'll never find the time. You'll never find a convenient time to get saved. You'll never find a convenient time to dedicate your life to God. Isn't it amazing what we're planning on doing tomorrow? Isn't it amazing the wonderful things that we're going to do tomorrow? How that we're going to be dedicated tomorrow? We're going to tithe tomorrow. We're going to be dedicated, sold out to God tomorrow. We're going to really begin a prayer life tomorrow. We're really going to begin to study the Word of God tomorrow. So many things we plan to do tomorrow. But he that observeth the winds shall not sow, and he that regardeth the clouds shall not reap. You'll never find that convenient time to be dedicated. You'll never find that convenient time to start tithing. You'll never find that convenient time to begin to witness. You'll never find that convenient time to put God first in your life. You'll never find that convenient time to be faithful. And you always project things so easy to postpone. You know, if you don't want to serve God, you can find plenty of excuses. If you don't want to be dedicated, you'll find plenty of excuses. There's many things that must be attended to in the proper season, or it's forever too late. Don't trade certainties for maybes. You know, going to heaven, living for the Lord, traveling the narrow road isn't an escalator ride. It sure isn't. Jesus says, strive to enter in. My friend, is there a time when Satan is going to be inactive? Is there ever going to be a convenient time for you to really dedicate your life to God because Satan is going to go on vacation? No, my friend, there's never going to be a convenient time, for the devil is never going to quit, and he's never going on vacation. He's not going to leave you alone. There's many difficulties in serving God, and my friend, there's going to be winds and clouds. I'm talking about there's going to be things to hinder and get in your way and stop you and slow you down. There's going to be doubts and fears and weaknesses and strong resistance. And there's not going to be a convenient time nor an easy time to do those things that you know you ought to be doing for God. I wonder what folks are going to do when they come to the close of life and they face God with their life's record. I know a lot of folks, you know, they have the idea I can get saved and then live as I please, and I'm safe, I'm secure, I'll never be lost and all of that. My friend, let me approach it from this angle. How are you going to feel when you stand before God and you've just lived a slipshod, haphazard life and your life hasn't counted to the hill of beans for God and you've just played around and played religion and all that sort of thing? Now, anybody with common sense is not going to stand up and tell me, oh, I'm all right, and I'll not be afraid, and there's nothing to worry about. I'm saved, and I'm secure, and it doesn't matter what I do. I'm going to be all right. Don't tell me you're going to stand before God without fear, my friend, because you've had a lifetime to serve God. You've played around, and you've done your own thing, and you've lived selfishly, and you've haven't been faithful to the church. You haven't backed the preacher. You've hopped around from here and there and done very little of anything at all, and stand before God unafraid. No, my friend, I tell you what, I believe you're going to be embarrassed, and you're going to be scared to death, because you've had a lifetime, but you've observed the winds and the clouds. You haven't amounted to anything for God. So many folks like that. Listen, we must not look upon the difficulties as impossible. If we look upon a man's fallen nature and observe that, just remember how that we are victims of a fallen nature and how that interrupts so much of our life. We'll not try to do much of anything. Too often we look at the clouds and the winds and we forget that God can change both the clouds and the winds. I mean, we've looked at the dark side of things and the difficult side and the hard side of things. We've observed the winds when it was time to sow, and we've watched the clouds when it was time to reap. And many of you were saved because You stopped observing the winds and the clouds. You got busy, and you got serious about serving God. We spend too much time weighing and measuring difficulties, my friend. God is able to change circumstances. If we had observed the winds and the clouds, my friend, if we do, we won't pray because we're not in the mood. How many times have you neglected to pray because you wasn't in the mood, you wasn't inspired? Much of the time, I'm not in the mood for praying. Much of the time, I'm not inspired to pray. Brother, I know it's my duty, my obligation to pray, and I have to battle my way through coldness and mind wandering and all that sort of thing. I have to battle my way through that. You're not going to find a convenient time. I mean, an easy time. The devil will remind you of so many things you need to do, and he'll interfere in so many ways. And so if you're going to observe the winds and the clouds, you won't tithe because you can't afford it. You won't sow nor reap because you're too timid. You won't have the power of God because you won't wrestle with God. You'll never kick the habits because you don't find a convenient time to do that. If somebody says, well, if I had the money, I'll tell you what I'd do. Well, do it anyway. If I had the talent, I'd tell you what I'd do. Do it anyway. If I had the right personality, I'd tell you what I'd do. Do it anyway. If I had the education, I'd tell you I'd do great things for God. Do it anyway. If I had the ability that some folks had, I'd tell you what I'd do. Well, do it anyway. God will help you because, my friend, God can withhold the clouds and the winds for you. And, sinner friend, I want to say if you observe the winds and the clouds, you'll never be saved. If you observe the weaknesses and the habits that hold you down, you'll never be saved. If you consider the environment and the heredity and the home training, then you'll never be saved. If you consider the difficulties, you'll never be saved. If you consider the crowd and the past and the depths of sin that you have fallen, you'll never be saved. But my friend, I just want to say, God can change and withhold the winds and the clouds, and God can bring every one of us through to victory, that we can make our life count for God and then not be ashamed to stand before Him. Be able to say with Paul of old, fought a good fight, finished my course, kept the faith, there's a crown waiting for me.